Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Blessed be the name of the Lord, the faithful Father, the Lord who never failed, the Lord who never changed. Thank Him because gradually He's taking us to the end of May. He has taught us yesterday that by the reason of sacrifices that we make wholeheartedly, wrath will be overturned. As He leads you into taking some steps, like you have prayed yesterday, don't forget to make up the sacrifice in order that you can be free from the wrath of the Almighty God and the challenges of your life. Well, today is Saturday, the 20th day of May. It is my prayer that this weekend will be a fantastic weekend for you. And the topic today says, how often do you fast? How regular do you fast? Or is it when it is declared alone that you pick up fasting? Do you have programs for yourself on fasting? So this study of today will lead us into knowing the importance of fasting so that we can move forward both spiritually and physically. Shall we just bow our heads to worship Him and pray? I give you glory, Lord, as I honor you. I give you glory, Lord, as I honor you. You are wonderful. You are worthy, O Lord. You are wonderful. You are worthy, O Lord. We give you glory, we give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, as we honor you, we give you glory, Lord. As we honor you, you are wonderful. You are worthy, O Lord. You are wonderful. You are the Messiah. You are wonderful. You are Jehovah Jireh. You are wonderful. You are Jehovah Rapha. Yes, Father, you are wonderful. We give you glory. We honor you. We magnify you. Thank you. Thank you for the teachings of this particular season on how we can connect with you so that any anger, anywhere we have provoked you, Father, you will overlook by the reason of the sacrifice you demand from us. We have made up our mind, our Father and our God, that we will key into whatever sacrifice you are demanding from us. Help us, eternal Father. And one of the sacrifices is fasting. Our Lord and our Father, you teach us how to subject the flesh, my Father, to the Spirit on this from today, in the name of Jesus. Thank you. In Jesus' name, we are prayed. Amen. How often do you fast? How often, my brother? How often, my sister, do you fast? The memory verse of today is taken from 2 Corinthians 11:27. 2 Corinthians 11:27 says, in weariness and painfulness, in watchings often, in hunger and thirst, in fasting often, in cold and nakedness. From this verse, we see some things that have been differentiated. And it was talking about hunger and thirst. That is different from fasting. You can be hungry, you can be thirsty. Does not mean that you are fasting. There are things attached to fasting. It says, in fasting often. There are situations that led him into environments where he didn't have food to eat. I was talking about Apostle Paul. But at those times, he was just hungry and thirsty. And there were times he set apart to fast often. Our Bible passage is in Matthew 6:16-18. Matthew 6:16-18. Say, moreover, when ye fast, be not as the hypocrites, of a sad countenance, for they disfigure their faces, that they may appear unto men to fast. Verily I say unto you, they have their reward. But thou, when thou fastest, anoint thy head and wash thy face, that thou appear not unto men to fast, but unto the Father which is in secret. And thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. Like I said briefly, the verse 16 made it clear that you don't behave like an hypocrite when you are fasting. But when you are hungry, people can see it on your face. They say, have you eaten anything today? I can say, yes, I've not eaten. Then people can help you, can come around. But when you have decided to fast, if you don't let it show on your face, Jesus made it known how to fast. This should not be an outward show. Don't show it that you have never eaten. Make up your mind the way you will really compose yourself. Neither by your appearance nor by your proclamation. Some people are fasting and you're talking and you say, don't you know I'm fasting? That is not the way Jesus required to fast. No. Don't talk to me now because I'm fasting. Fasting is a spiritual exercise. And it has to be carried out regularly. The way we do the physical exercise, we need the spiritual exercise. Fasting are prayers so that we might develop. Many of us, we have our time for jogging. We have our time when we go to develop our muscles and to shed some weight. In the same manner, when we come before God in prayer and fasting, our spiritual man develops. We get stronger in the spirit. That is why God wants us to get involved regularly in fasting. So this should be a private thing that we do. From the study, since one of Daddy was giving a testimony, he said, one of my sons was traveling with me for the very first time some time ago. And after we had been together for 2 days, he asked me, Daddy, why do you pray so much? For these 2 days, I've observed it. Why? He said, he observed that before we left the room, we prayed. When we got into the car, we prayed. On arrival at our destination, we prayed. Even when we entered the venue of the program, we prayed. When we finished the program, we prayed. On arrival at our lodging place, we prayed also. Can see? Prayer, it should be our lifestyle. No wonder. The Bible has already instructed us in 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without ceasing. In every step you are taking, pray. Because you don't know what is ahead. You don't know. Some people left their houses in order to enter into their cars where it was parked in the garage. Something happened to them. Anything can happen any moment, but when you are accustomed to prayers, committing yourself into the Lord's hand, enter into the car, you pray. Father, lay your hands on this vehicle today. Lay your hands on this particular driver. Guide us in this journey. Angels of God, surround us. And you go. And the Almighty God knows how to prevent evil in such a way. When you get down where you are at where you are going, you need to thank him also. Thank you for taking us safely. Thank you, Jesus, for this particular 5 minutes trip. You thank him for the 5 minutes as you will thank him for the 2 hours. And in fact, in the 2 hours of driving, you will still be communicating with him because the guiding angels should be with you. If God's presence is not with you in a moment, you are finished. You need his presence in every stage of life. And this observation also went further. He said, when he peeped to check Daddy, even in his room, he saw him on his knees. We have prayed in so many stages. And after we entered down, Daddy entered into his room, he still knelt down, prayed. So when you finish a roundup of the work of the day, do you enter into the house to pray? Or you say you are engaged. I have some assignments I want to do. Huh? The Almighty God that has kept you through the assignment of the few hours. You need to honor him. Bless his name for leading you all through. For leading you all through. Well, that he says, I pray a lot because prayer is an activity that we are commanded always to engage in 1 Thessalonians 5:17. So the question is, how often do you pray? Do you use every available opportunity to pray? It's a question for you and I. Do we use every available opportunity to pray? And I want to look at the scriptures as per the instructions and the lifestyle of Jesus. In Luke 18 verse 1, Jesus even admonished us here. And he said, he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. Men always ought to pray and not to faint. Not to lose heart. Not to lose heart. And we can see this. The Lord who said it demonstrated it in so many ways. He demonstrated it. I see Mark chapter 1 and verse 35. Mark 1 and verse 35. And in the morning, rising up a great while before day, he went out and departed into a solitary place. And there prayed. In the morning. Rose up very early. Went to a very sacred place to pray. To call on the Lord. And to commit the day into the Lord's hand. To commit the day into his Lord's hands. And in chapter 6 of that same Acts, of the same Mark, and we see that in verses 45 and 46. 45 and 46. And straightway, he constrained his people, his disciples, to get into the ship. After feeding the 5,000. After feeding the 5,000. After the miracle, he constrained the people to the ship and go to the other side before unto Bethsaida, while he sent away the people. And when he had sent them away, he departed into a mountain to pray. He went into a mountain to pray. After finishing the work of the feeding of the 5,000, even the miracle worker himself went to pray. But what do we do in our own side? When the miracles are happening, we come back, we sit down, we start chatting. Can't you see me? Can't you see what I'm doing? Can see the miracles that the miracle worker himself went to pray. That is, when the battery has been discharged, you need to go and recharge. You need to go and recharge. In Luke chapter 5, verse 16, also showed it there to us. It says, and he withdrew himself into the wilderness and prayed. You can see, he showed us example. So you can also look at Luke chapter 6, verse 12, there also. And it came to pass in those days that he went out into the mountain to pray and continued all night in prayer to God. All night prayers. When it is time to call for vigil, all night prayers, don't you query it. Say, why should I abandon my bed to come around in the church to pray? I pray that God will grant you sleep. It is when there is sleep that you enjoy your bed. And there's no sleep, when the challenge of life are bombarding your head, you don't have time to sleep. That waterbed will become nothing to you at all. But when you learn how to pray, how to seek the face of God, you abandon your bed. Be on your knees, walk around, pray, talk to God. Then you see the manifestation of the power of God in your life. So also you see it in John chapter 6 and verse 15. Jesus showed us example of how to pray. When Jesus therefore perceived that they will come and take him by force, to make him a king, he departed again into the mountain himself alone. So, we need to pray. It's a spiritual exercise. It's a spiritual exercise. Apart from prayer, under spiritual activity, you should regularly engage in to keep you spiritually fit and growing is fasting. Is fasting. Some people believe that doing a long fast for 30 days or 100 days is sufficient for a year. While this is a good spiritual exercise, there is still the need to continue fasting in the course of the year. The year is 365 days or 366. If you can cultivate an idea, a lifestyle, in the beginning of the year, you start about time, so at least enter into the year seeking the face of God. And you make up your mind, at this particular period of the month, I will still continue with my fasting. So while this is good, you still need to continue. When the Lord addressed the question, why his disciples were not fasting often, like those of John the Baptist, here is what he said in Luke 5:34. They asked him, you could see the disciples of John, they were always fasting, but yours, they are just coming around and they're feasting, always enjoying themselves. Jesus answered, said, but the days will come when the bridegroom shall be taken away from them, and then shall they fast in those days. When Jesus was around, when any need came up, Jesus was there to meet with the need instantaneously. Physically, he was with them. Physically, they wanted to ask, have you paid for the tax? He would just give a command. Have you done this one? He will just give a statement and it will settle. They were just enjoying their master because he was still around. But he said, immediately he's gone, he will fast. But now, the master has gone to glory. The master has gone to glory, and we are bound to start to fast. Since the master has been received into glory, it is clear from his words that we now are expected to fast often. Some people fast for a short period at a stretch, and thereafter they want to feast for the rest of the year. This is not good enough. A better practice is to find or create some time monthly, or better still, weekly, to engage in fasting. Make sure, weekly, at least if it is one day or two, weekly, set apart time to fast. Particularly, those of us that are the work of the ministry, Jesus made it clear there are some things that will not be accomplished except by prayer and fasting. That's why we must cultivate the attitude and the lifestyle of fasting. Fasting was not strange to the patriarchs of old. Fasting does you so much good spiritually. So it should be a part of your lifestyle. You can live a fasted life. While detailing his experiences in life, Apostle Paul, in 2 Corinthians 11:27, the memory verse, said that fasting was a recurring activity in his Christian life. Said in willingness, in painfulness, in watching often, in hunger and thirst, in fasting often, in cold and nakedness. Some things we should learn from this particular man. He went through all this, and he never allowed his faith in the Lord to be shaken. Are you passing through any of this today and you are already complaining? This man never complained. He never complained. He was focused to the end, to the time when he said, I've finished my course. I pray that you will finish, and I will also finish well, in the name of Jesus. Most people who find it difficult to fast simply have a problem with discipline. They are so used to eating that they cannot sacrifice a few meals to seek God's face. Are you like that? Can't miss my lunch. Can't miss my breakfast. Things like that. But I want to let you know that it is the flesh waging war against you. It is the flesh. The flesh will not want your spirit man to develop at all. Hence, watch it. There are sometimes you are busy. You just get out of the house. Maybe you are packed even your breakfast. You get to your office. You met some things on ground and you started to deal with them. And by around 3 or 4, you just remember, I've not even taken my breakfast. That day you never planned to fast, and yet the body did not react. But the day you say, tomorrow I will be fasting, by 5 a.m., your stomach is already punching you for food. The flesh will always wage war when it realizes that your spirit man wants to grow. And that is why you need to put the flesh under control. Put the flesh under control. Anyone who cannot control his or his appetite may remain enslaved to the body. Fasting helps to subdue or break the controlling power that the weaknesses and desires of your body have over you. Hence, the body will start to resist. The flesh is always wanting to work against the spirit. Look at it in Galatians chapter 5, verse 17. Galatians 5, 17 says, for the flesh lusteth against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. and these are contrary the one to the other, so that ye cannot do the things that ye would. The flesh will not want you to do that that is expected of you. But remember, those who fasted in the scriptures, who subdued the flesh for victory. Remember the case of Esther? In Esther chapter 4 and verses 16 and 17. 4, 16 and 17 say, go gather together all the Jews that were present in Shushan, and fast ye for me, and neither eat nor drink 3 days, night or day. I also and my maidens will fast likewise. And so will I go unto the king, which is not according to the law. And if I perish, I perish. So Mordecai went his way and did according to all that Esther had commanded him. And you know the rest of the story in chapter 5 and 4 and after. Favor arose for Esther and the children of Israel. You want favor in your life? You need moment with God. A sacrifice of fasting and prayer. Fasting and prayer. So also, you see what happened in the book of Jonah, chapter 3, verses 4 and 5. Chapter 3, verses 4 and 5. And Jonah began to enter into the city a day's journey. And he cried and said, yet 40 days, and Nineveh shall be overthrown. So the people of Nineveh believed God and proclaimed a fast and put a sackcloth from the greatest of them even to the least of them. You can read further. The king also joined them in the fasting, because the judgment of God was dangling over the city. And they resolved, we are going to make a sacrifice of fasting and prayer. And the judgment of God was reversed. It was reversed. So, if you're having a challenge in your life, you need to wait on God. You need to wait on God. In Acts 13 verse 2, Acts 13 verse 2, talking about leadership in the church, it says, as they ministered to the Lord and fasted, the Holy Ghost said, separate me, Barnabas, and Saul for the work whereunto I have called them. They needed to move forward in the work of the kingdom. They fasted. They were not fasting because they needed to send somebody, but fasting had become their lifestyle. They were ministering to God in fasting and prayer. They were just enjoying the presence of the Almighty God. When God now said, I've seen this, let me give you another direction. When you engage in fasting and prayers, more revelations will come as per the way to move forward. That will be your portion in the name of Jesus. So waiting on the Lord is very crucial for you to connect with destiny and make wonders happen in your life. That's why I want to mention to you again Isaiah 40, 31, and they that wait upon the Lord. Waiting upon the Lord in fasting and prayer, say, you shall renew your strength. Physical strength, spiritual strength, financial strength, marital strength, strength all around shall be renewed. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. You no longer be a crawler. You now be soaring. Yes, he says, they shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and never faint. You want to connect with this particular realm and experience in life. Engage in waiting on God, in fasting and prayers. So the action point of this is, stop talking about your plan to fast. Just go ahead and fast. You can start with one day per week. So, bow down your heads and talk to the Almighty God. Say, Father, help me to be effective in the prayer, in the be effective in the place of prayer and fasting. Help me to be effective, O God, in the place of prayer and fasting, in the name of Jesus. This particular exercise, this particular spiritual exercise is needed in my life. Help me to be effective, my Lord and my God, in the prayer, in the place of prayer and fasting, in the name of Jesus. Father my God, so that my body will be subdued, the flesh will be subdued, my spiritual, my Lord, the man will continue to grow, my Lord and my God, so that I will connect with destiny. Help me, O God, to be effective in the place of prayer and fasting, in the name of Jesus. I say that the body be subdued today, in the name of Jesus. The body, hear me, O God. I say the body be subdued today. The flesh be subdued today, in the name of Jesus. That we swear, Lord, in the name of Jesus, help me, O God, that I will be able to wait upon you regularly. Help me, help me, help me. Cry unto God, and as I wait upon you, Father, renew my strength. As I learn to wait upon you from now on, start to renew my strength. Physical strength, spiritual strength, marital strength, financial strength. Lord, help me. Eternal Father, help me to renew my strength. As I wait upon you regularly from now on, cause my spiritual strength to be renewed, physical strength to be renewed, financial strength to be renewed, my marital strength to be renewed. In all realms, oh Father, my God, cause me, oh God, my strength to be renewed ministerially, in the name of Jesus. Thank you for hearing us, oh God. In Jesus' name we pray. Father, as your children have cried unto you today, Father, hear us from above. Lord, release that grace of fasting and prayer upon us in the name of Jesus. And as we wait upon you, Father, let there be constant renewal of strength for your children in all areas of life. Thank you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Join us as we sing this hymn, Deeper, Deeper. God bless you.
Open the floodgates of heaven. Let
gates of hell. Sing out, let it.